go.
It's like all handle too.
Beautiful. Those aren't pretty, but they get through.
Yeah.
Good. You don't have to hit it hard. You just gotta push it.
I promise I wouldn't have swung that in the game.
I would have, but that's what I was looking for. Beautiful.
When I get them outside like that, it's easy to do it. It's the middle stuff that... I bumped too hard.
There's that middle.
It comes off the handle, but it works.
Beautiful. You got your hips moving out a little bit early on that one.
My bad. Yeah, I found that middle swing in Florida, and it's just been working like a beauty, but I feel bad in league ball doing it.
Beautiful. Stay fair.
Stay fair. Oh.
Yeah, sadly, it's more... It really is a lot of just wrist snapping right on.
It is. And, like, I see people do it and they're, like, fading away.
Nope. No need to do it.
But I feel it. Like, I'm not doing it, but I feel where that...
Yeah. That was that middle ball.
Oh, I got under it.
It's really important to get those hands really still before you come forward, especially backside.
Yeah.
There you go. That pitch is in the exact same spot as the one you just missed.
I did not even move my hands until I ran away from it and then just threw.
Yep.
That felt good.
Beautiful.
Uh-oh.
So you feel that when you were hitting about 850.
Yeah. Might be right at second, but...
No, it's right at the 5-man. That's not at the second baseman. Plus, that ball was coming.
That might be out. Jesus!
Are you trying to lose your ball?
Give me a reason to buy more. That was all barrel and everything.
Right, I went inside on that.
Yeah, I saw it and I tried to like drop hands and swing down through it, but...
Good ball. Good speed.
Swung early.
Yeah.
My first handful might come back middle on accident.
Whatever, man. Here's a screen here. Definitely wouldn't back up the middle. I feel like those were a little high. Are they a little high?
The first couple ones were. Right. That one is a little lower. That was a good pitch. Right. And I was outside. I should have taken that backside, but... Wow, that really does have a ring to it.
Yeah, when you're getting it off the sweet spot, it sure does. But even like I've heard like the really broken in ones still have a lot of noise to
it. It almost sounds like an alloy. Oh, you 6 foot tall guy.
Here's a really good ball. The exit velo on there is a little better than the Mizuno, just from eyeball.
You think so?
Just eyeball says the exit velo is a little better, but that one's still got more carry to it.
Yeah. Cause that's out with the Mizuno.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stay full side.
Alright.
I'll put one on the other field. That was the first time I felt like I loaded my hands well. I got way out in front of that ball.
So that is the negative byproduct of taking BP backside is you unconsciously stop loading your hands. Yeah, your timing is a little bit off. You're out in front on some. You're letting some of them get a little deep. That ball's good. Hey, those low ones you keep leaning way back on, trying to get those hands lower. Get down and push those hips forward. So instead of leaning back like this,
stay down.
Come
on
forward and drive your hips upward through the ball.
Give me a couple.
Just like that. You go back and watch the tape, you're going to see your hips moved about 3 feet forward.
And stayed upright.
Yeah. You got four in here.
Back there.
You're gonna see how much room and back you're doing.
I think it's because I feel like I'm getting ahead and I'm trying to slow myself down.
But if you're getting ahead, that's when you really need to start putting the rest of your body in your swing.
I mean, like mid-swing, I feel like, oh, I mistimed it.
Right, but that's when you, instead of leaning back to slow down or speed up, that's when you realize, all right, my timing's off here. I need to put the more body into my swing and kind of step in through it.